welcome back to the San Antonio Zoo. Yoga is happening now. Now is all there is. And we have some friends joining us, the American Black Bears. Our friends are having their breakfast. Thank you for joining us, Bears. And thank you for joining us, friends. A big shout out to all of my Will Smith Zoo School friends. Oh, I miss you all so, so much. I woke up feeling a little rough this morning. I want to know how you're feeling. I had to put a red shirt on because I needed color. I needed more brightness on this dreary day. It makes me happy. So what makes you happy? I want to know what makes you happy, and I want you to tune into that. There is so much mayhem right now, but let's put that in the back seat, right? It's not going anywhere. Let's think about and focus on all of the wonderful things that are happening right now, right here in front of us. We're gonna start in a seat. Find your comfortable seat. I always like to move my cushions out of the way so I can let my seat bones really make contact with the floor or the mat. If you have a blanket that you'd like to sit on, you can bring your hips up higher than the knees, and that's helpful. Again, once you're nice and settled, you can begin to close your eyes if you'd like. It might be hard to close your eyes when you have a great scenery behind you, but go inward. Focus on you with eyes open or closed. Feel strong in that foundation and begin to breathe naturally. Let your navel draw in and feel your breath transform your body. Unhinge your jaw. If you carry a lot of tension here, as I do, you can unhinge your jaw, drop your lower jaw from your upper jaw, and just wiggle it. And let's take a few inhales through the nose first. Big inhale, fill yourself up completely. And then open your mouth and sigh it out. I'm going to do a handful of those. Inhale slow and gently through the nose. And then open your mouth and sigh it out. This time, let's engage our arms. On your next inhale, reach your arms out and up. Inhale through the nose. Exhale, arms come down. Inhale, arms up. Through the nose, the breath comes. Exhale, sigh it out gently. Last inhale, leave your arms up overhead, palms touching perhaps. And then exhale, take it over towards the left. Your left hand walks on out, right arm comes over. Gaze up towards the sky or the ceiling on the inside of that right arm. Take a few deep breaths here, maybe three. Keep that right hip grounded, and remember the unraveling of that fascia with the breath will help you to go deeper and deeper with each breath. After your third breath or so, come back to center. Inhale, palms touch. Exhale over towards the right. left hip wants to lift on up because you want to go further, but keep that hip down. Let the stretch come here. The elasticity of your muscles increases with the lengthening of your breath. Do a back and forth now. On your next inhale, come back to center. Exhale to the left. Inhale up. Exhale over. Inhale up. Exhale over. Tap into your own flow. Go at the pace that serves your body well. Ujjayi breath, inhales and exhales through the nose. Once you're balanced on both sides, come back to center and close your eyes. Bring your hands on your knees at first. Feel how much more alive you might be feeling. Shifting that energy already. Be aware of that. And then bring your hands onto your heart. You can slightly bow your chin here. Take a moment to connect with your inner being. I'm inviting you to trust in your inner wisdom. Everything you need is right here inside of you. That's why we are here today, to tap into that inner calm, so that no matter what happens on the outside, we can stay grounded, we can stay peaceful. Open and take a big inhale through your nose. Reach your arms out and up. Exhale, bring your right hand to your left knee. Bring your left hand right behind you. Here's a side view if that's more helpful. So really pressing your left palm down, so we're grounding down to rise up. Let your spine be long, crown of your head going higher. Take a big inhale, send that left shoulder back, and then take the gaze in that direction. Spinal twist, engage in the neck as well. Take about 5 to 7 deep breaths here. We're not forcing into it. See where you can soften, and let your breath unravel. Of your feet, maybe bring the opposite foot in front if you'd like. And then again, big inhale, reach your arms out and up. Exhale, left hand on your right knee, right hand right behind you. Get yourself situated. Take a big inhale, lift your chest, take that right shoulder behind you. And exhale, take your gaze there. It is springtime, a wonderful time for detox, an internal cleanse. It all begins with the breath. Breath wash through you on that last inhale. Sit a little taller, crown of your head goes higher. Exhale, twist a little deeper comfortably, and then unwind, come back to center. Come up to your tabletop. We're gonna do another little flow this way. Bringing it up a little bit, bring your shoulders over your wrists as usual, hips over knees, navel draws in. Gazing down in between your thumbs or your index fingers. You're wanting to press those two fingers in a lot. You're pressing into your fingertips and your knuckles here, getting that pressure off your wrists. And then, when you're ready for engaging your breath with a cat-cow, feel free to join me. Inhale, drop your belly, lift your gaze, lift your tailbone. Exhale, round your spine, tuck your chin, scoop your tailbone. Inhale for cow, pull those shoulders away from your ears. Exhale for cat. Inhale, one more, just like this. And then come back to center when you're ready. Hi, friend. We're going to do a little flow here. Let's inhale, left leg behind you, foot is flexed, and your right arm out in front of you. Palm facing up so you have that outer rotation in your shoulder. Navel draws in, inhale to lengthen, and then exhale, draw your knee to your nose, elbow to knee. A gentle balancing pose, draw in through your center. Inhale, get long. Exhale, draw in. Inhale again. Exhale, draw in. We're going to change it up a bit. This time, inhale, lengthen, but bend your left knee. And then as you exhale, reach your right arm out to the right and your left leg out towards the left. Inhale, get long. Exhale, draw in. Inhale, extend. Bend your knee, reach out to either side on your exhale. Inhale, get long, last one. Exhale, drawing in. Inhale, see if you can get longer here. Bend your knee, reach out to either side on that exhale. Inhale, and then exhale back to center. Bring your hips onto your heels. Let's rotate those wrists. A lot of pressure on that left wrist. Let's pull those left fingertips down towards the mat. Just relax your shoulders. Give me a nice gentle wrist stretch here. I always like to take the time. I like to pull on one finger at a time and use my breath to just explore the sensation. When you are completely aware, you're able to see and notice what needs to be acknowledged. And then you can flip your hand back on over, stretch your wrist the other way. to shake both wrists. We prepare for the other side. Come back on up into your tabletop. This time, once you're nice and grounded and ready, inhale, right leg straight behind you, foot is flexed, active, really active in that leg, and then left arm out in front of you with your thumb up, outer rotation on the shoulder. Keep your gaze down towards your mat, so the crown of your head is going towards that wall or the space in front of you, chin is slightly tucked. Inhale, extend, draw your navel in. Exhale, draw inward. Knee to nose, elbow to knee. Inhale, extend, get long. Exhale, draw in. Feel your strong breath, inhales and exhales through the nose. We'll change it up here, so inhale, get long, and then exhale, bend your right knee, reach out to either side, left arm out to the left, right leg out to the right. Inhale, get long, exhale, draw in. Inhale, get long, bend the knee, exhale, reach out to either side. Inhale, get long. Exhale, draw in. Inhale, get longer on this last one. Exhale, bend that knee and reach out. Inhale, last time to get the longest. And then slowly bring your hips back to your heels. Woo, let's work on that right wrist now. Shaking both wrists out, but then taking extra care of that right wrist. You can bring your hand out in front of you, fingertips pointing down towards your mat or your floor, and just gently tug on that. If you do a lot of computer work, which I think most of us are doing now, this can serve you well. Feel free to play along with one finger at a time. Relaxing your shoulders. And then flipping your palm over, stretching the other side of the wrist here. My heart rate has lifted. Perhaps yours has as well. I always have my water close by. Feel free to take a break. Drink some water. In these classes, we're always moving a lot of energy. And to keep our bodies happy and healthy, one great way of doing that is to stay hydrated. Drink lots of water. All right, after your water break, let's come upright a little bit. Let's meet in downward facing dog. Separate your fingers wide. Tuck your toes, send those hips high. Ooh, I got a pop in my back. Thank you, buddy. Move around, warm up. Stretch the backs of those legs by bending one knee at a time. Shake your head no. Release any tension in your jaw, your neck. Let your head be as heavy as a head truly is. And then see if you can find a still dog and find some contentment there. Loving yourself just the way you are. Your pose is perfect. It is beautiful. Better and better all the time. Inhale, lift your right leg high. Exhale, bend your knee, step through, warrior one. Make as much space for your hips as you need here. Maybe you're not on a tightrope where your heels are lined up. Maybe you're more
on a paycheck? Make as much space as you need, and then draw that right hip back, left hip forward. Keep in mind, the closer your feet are together, the more of a twist you're gonna feel in this pose. We're grounding down first, navel in, tailbone scoops. When you're ready to rise, join me. Press down into the big toe ball mound of your right foot. Inhale, lift your heart. Exhale, bring your right hand down. See if you can touch the inside of your left leg. Slight, mild back bends. That's where scooping your tailbone comes in handy. Inhale, come back on up. Exhale, plant your hands down. Step back. And we're going to lower all the way down to our bellies. Use your knees if you need to. Elbows graze the sides of your body. Untuck your toes. We'll come up for our first cobra. Inhale, reach on up. Legs active. Glutes active. Exhale, release. Inhale, come on up. Pull yourself through. We're using the low back muscles here. We start out slowly and begin to open up more and more with each breath. Inhale up. Exhale, release. Let's meet in downward facing dog. Use your knees if you need to, maybe plank. Take your time, no rush. This is such a wonderful time to force us to slow down. No rush, my friends. Take it easy. When you're ready, inhale your left leg high. And then exhale, step on through. Warrior one, this side. Different side, perhaps a different sensation. Left hip back, right hip forward as you draw your feet towards one another. Eraser edge side here, right foot really grounding down. Navel and tailbone scoops. Once you're nice and grounded, rise up and join me. Couple breaths here, shoulders staying away from the ears, lifting your heart. Inhale, prepare for a mild back bend if you choose. Right fingertips go higher, exhale, left fingertips touch the inside of your right leg. Vinyasa if you choose, or we will meet in downward facing dog. Exhale to lower. Inhale, cobra or up dog. Exhale, downward facing dog. Walk your hands back towards your feet. Standing forward fold. Uttanasana at the back of your mat. Let your head and arms be heavy. You can keep a micro bend in the knees or straighten your legs. Grab opposite elbows perhaps. Or clasp your hands at the back of your head or neck. Slow, gentle breaths. Riding the waves of that breath. Perhaps you can feel your heart beating a little more rapidly after that last flow. Enjoy that. You are alive and all is well. Bring your fingertips down to your mat or your shins by releasing your bind. And then inhale, lift up halfway. Tailbone scoop. Navel in.
navel draws in. Exhale, fold.
Inhale, halfway lift.
Exhale, fold.
Inhale, halfway lift.
Exhale, walk forward, downward facing dog.
Inhale, reach your right leg high. Exhale, step on through, warrior two. I like to revisit the same poses often. How does your warrior two feel today? Get that right knee right over your ankle. Opening the hip. Reach on out. Another flow from here. Inhale, reach your arms forward, and then take it back to reverse. Inhale, reach it forward. Exhale, take it back. Inhale, take it forward and maybe down. Maybe your right elbow comes onto your knee. Not using too much weight there. You're using the strength of your side waist on the left. Or you can bring your hand down on the inside of that right foot. Inhale, come back on up and take it back to reverse. Exhale, take it forward in whichever way you choose. Let this be your dance. Let your breath guide you. Inhale up and back. Exhale, forward. Two more. Inhale up. Exhale down. Last one. You got this. Exhale, bring it down. Come back on up to warrior two. Straighten your front leg and let's come into triangle. Trikonasana. Bring your left hand behind you to grab a hold of your right thigh, or you can put your left hand on your left hip, fingertips pointing right in front of you. Press down into the big toe ball mound of your right foot, hinge forward, and then reach down somewhere on the inside of your right leg. We're not trying to touch the floor again, strengthening the side waist here. Spin that left shoulder behind you. You can bring your left fingertips high. Take a few deep breaths here. Let your ujjayi breath turn off that fight, flight, or freeze response. You are rewiring your brain. Inhale, come back to center, back into warrior two. And cartwheel your hands down. Take a vinyasa if you choose, slow and steady, mindful as you go, or we meet in down dog. One big inhale through the nose, and then open your mouth and let it go. Inhale your left leg high. Exhale, step on through, warrior two. Our last little flow of lifting the heart rate, and then we'll bring it back down. Hang in there. Feel free to pause. Take a drink of water, ground down, navel and tailbone scoops, shoulders out, arms out, shoulders drawing in, kissing on your butt. And let the flow begin. Inhale, reach your left fingertips forward, and then take it back for reverse. Inhale up and forward. reverse. Inhale up and forward. Exhale, release right hand out on the outside of that right leg. Or you can wrap it around here and reach for the inside of your left thigh. Inhale, come back to center. And then we're going to bring in elbow down first, or the inside of your leg with the fingertips. Inhale, prepare. Exhale, bring it down, elbow maybe. Maybe hand here. And then take it back. Exhale. Inhale, take it forward. In whichever way you chose on the other side. Exhale, take it back. Sing your song, dance your dance. Synchronize your breath with your movement. Two more here, you've got this. Last one, feel your power here. Feeling grounded? Exhale, bring it down, except for not, because we're coming back to warrior two to straighten that left leg. We're gonna come into Trikonasana. Bring your right hand on your right hip, or you can reach it around behind you. That'll draw that right shoulder back. Left fingertips straight in front of you here. Ground down through the big toe ball mound of your left foot. Inhale, lift your chest. And then exhale, hinge forward and down. Somewhere on the inside of this leg, strengthening the side waist on this side. Send that right shoulder behind you. Arm comes high to the sky. With each breath, open your heart more, letting your fingertips reach away from each other more and more. A few breaths here. If you have blocks, you can use a block in a pose like this. If you're doing this, remember, let's strengthen the side waist here and not put too much pressure on the elbow. One more breath, last breath. And then slowly come on up, warrior two. Inhale, we're calling our last vinyasa here, if you're ready. Exhale, cartwheel your hands down. Squeeze in your last vinyasa if you'd like. Always available to use your knees. Dog. Walk your feet up towards your hands. Let's see. Let's do Malasana. Heels in, toes out. Nice inner thigh. And hip stretch. Bring your hands to your heart. Stay here for a good 30 seconds or so, lowering our heart rate. Feel free to lower yourself down to your mat whenever you're ready, in whatever way works best for you. I'm really good at just plopping down. Come onto your back when you're ready. Take a good 30 seconds or so, maybe a minute. Let's lay down in reclining mountain pose. Let's let our body reset itself, rebalance itself,
letting our heart rate lower. You don't have to control anything here. You just get to be. You're not offering any effort. You are just enjoying the bliss of your hard work and the benefits you are receiving from it. Looking to see if we still have a good view of the American black bears.
They're so cute!
Oh, thank you, San Antonio Zoo, for keeping us all together, helping us all to keep the hope, keep the faith. Feel free to stay on your back, take a little nap if you'd like, or gently ease your way up to a seat.
Remember, friends, positive emotions can boost your immune system. I hope I've helped you to do that today. And know that you've got it within you. Everything you need is right inside. Don't doubt yourself. Thank you, San Antonio Zoo.
Thank you, American black bears.
Until next time, many blessings.